you just kind of go, wow, am I going to, you know, I just celebrated a birthday. I'm looking and thinking to myself, and I'm going, am I going to have another one? Well, growing up as an athlete, I like competition. I've always been competitive. This one was something that I wasn't expecting, but I was up for it. And my first words to the doctor were, what's my next step? If any of you are familiar with ovarian cancer, the possibility without having any type of chemotherapy of it coming back is 80%. Holy crap, that's pretty high odds. But I'm going, okay, 20%, I'm up for 20%. I said, okay, what happens if I do chemotherapy? You cut it in half, 40%. My odds are much better. That was in 2001. My doctor, my surgeon was absolutely phenomenal. She'd already talked to five doctors. She said, you know, we'll get you set up, all this stuff. Start your chemo. Started chemo. I was very fortunate on the chemo that I only had to do it every week. Every Friday, I would go to the doctor. I'd sit in a little chair. I had a port put in. So that the IV just, it went right in there. Yeah, it's, you know, some of you guys don't fall. But yeah, I had a port put in. It's a lot easier. The drugs go in a lot quicker. And less pain for me to have that port. But I'm going back up. Telling my family that it was cancer was difficult. I called my mom. She lives in South Dakota. I lived in southern Arizona at the time. I called my mom, and I told her. And my mom just kind of was, I mean, it took her aback, but she was very, very supportive from the get-go. And she goes, I know you're up for the challenge. So anyway, I did my chemo. While I was doing my chemo, my caregivers, oh my God, thank you, caregivers. I'm guessing we have quite a few caregivers. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Going through chemotherapy would not be the same without caregivers. If you guys know a caregiver, tell them thanks. Survivors, make sure you tell those caregivers thank you. And caregivers don't have to be somebody that takes you to the doctor or things like that. I mean, they're nurses, they're doctors, they're brothers, sisters, cousins, friends, classmates, teachers, whatever. My family sent me hats. I would get two or three different kinds of hats a week from my family and my friends. And over 6 months, I got a lot of hats. Anyway, they put me on steroids to combat the nausea, and I don't like steroids. I woke up, I was awake like at 2 o'clock in the morning, and I was very happy for the internet because I would get on the internet and I would look up information. But going through chemo, one thing, I could look it up twice, three times, because a lot of times with the chemo, you forget what you looked at. So I had to start writing this stuff down. I got onto the American Cancer Society, cancer.org, and there's a survivor network on there. And you can join it. You can read stories of other survivors, and that's very, very powerful to be able to do. You don't have to be a survivor to go onto the American Cancer Society, cancer.org's website. Also, they have the toll-free number, 800-227-2345. One thing that's wonderful about that, there's somebody there 24/7, 365 days a year. You don't have to be a survivor. You don't have to be a caregiver. You have questions. use it. Don't hesitate to use it. If they can't answer it right then and there, then we'll find an answer and they will give you a jingle back and let you know. They're very, very good. People call them all the time. They just need somebody to talk to. If you know somebody that needs to talk to somebody and they don't have anybody close by, give them that number, 800-227-2345. The web can be beneficial. The web can also be overwhelming when you get out there and start reading your stuff. What does your money do? People always forget the four things that they do. And it's very, very easy to remember. And most of us have years, education, advocacy, research, and services. So if somebody, you're out asking somebody for money and they go, well, what's it go for? Reach up, touch your ears, education, advocacy, research, and services. You guys got a lot of future ahead of you. And I understand that you guys are very, very good at joining in camp. And please do, these people are dealing with your future. Get involved with it now. You may not be able to vote, but your voices are still heard. Please join, get on there, let these folks know how you feel, if there's something coming up. Get the emails. They come, respond to them, let them know. You can tell them that you're, at this time, you're probably not old enough to vote, but, you're playing with my future. I want to have the ability to do something with that. Raise some funds, have fun. When I was a teenager, I would do just about anything to have an excuse to stay out all night. Go for it. Go for it. Raise money. Let's find a cure so you don't have to tell your children it's cancer. Thank you. Get some money out there. Go for it, guys.